didn't know if there was gonna be like 20 people and bodyguards.
Hey, Mom, he's gonna get his own room. Will that be okay?
When that elevator opened and he stepped out, you know, I had two thoughts. First was, wow, it's really...
Basically, how the trip started was my sister couldn't come with us, and my parents gave me the option of bringing along a friend. I asked if Mac would come along.
Brock said that Mac had a friend who was talking about joining us in Bermuda.
It seemed possible, but we didn't know how much of it was talk.
We were okay, well, that's fine. Who is his friend? And Brock said, it's Michael Jackson.
We were still sort of like in disbelief when we got there.
Wow, it's really Michael Jackson. And where's everybody else? Because it was just him.
And he was extremely shy.
He said, come on up, let me show you what I brought. And we went up there, and that's when he opened up this footlocker full of Toys R Us.
I was just like, wow, that's so cool that he has a briefcase full of gag stuff. He's Michael Jackson, you know? And so, like, I caught on really fast that he wasn't like a typical adult.
And the moment he pulled those super soakers out, the kids grabbed him.
It's the suite of the hotel, right? And here these guys are soaking everything.
That's not a nice guy. You guys gotta be nice to Transfer.
I don't think so.
I didn't really know exactly what to do because one side of me, you know, the boy side that I guess is always in all males, they say, wanted to join in, and the other, the dad side, was like, I don't know if I should do that, until I got squirted.
I think one of the first days we went to the beach and we were just snorkeling, shooting water guns. Michael was there on the beach, but, you know, he was in full clothing.
Then he took his camera and walked into the water with his camera and was taking pictures of everybody.
For a second, he's just, you know, in the breeze, and he's starting to dance, you know? I feel like he was letting his guard down.
Everybody sure. Tells a corny joke, I'm gonna do that.
One night, Mac and Brock were watching a movie or something like that over in the other room, and we went out on the balcony, and that's when he came out with, he really missed not having a childhood. And that was one of the reasons why he ran around doing all these crazy things, because now he could do what he wanted, and he wanted to have the fun that he didn't get when he was a kid.
The thing that was abnormal is that here's a 30-year-old, you know, billion-dollar mega superstar that's essentially behaving like a child.
I remember a statement he made that, you know, kids are honest. You can trust them. He says, I haven't been around hardly any adults that haven't ended up wanting something from me.
When I first, you know, saw that on the news with the, you know, allegations of it, I didn't believe it because nothing like that ever happened with me.
I couldn't see it. I don't see it. My intuition says no, Michael wouldn't be like that.
One can only judge by one's own experience. So I can't say anything about what happened at Neverland, what happened with other people. I can only judge from our own experiences with Michael. So we're eating dessert and I hear this giggling. And I look up from eating and Michael's sitting right across from me. And he's got strawberry shortcake and a spoon, and he's got it like this. So the moment he hit that, it was strawberry shortcake everywhere. And it went on for 4 or 5 minutes. It was on the floor. People behind us got hit
all
over the place.
Unbelievable. Really, it was unbelievable.
They're certainly atypical for a 30-year-old guy. Very atypical for a billionaire star to do that. But he was an atypical person. He was a special individual.